trial and error might be a very expensive process. So you have to invent that it shouldn't be expensive. That means technically simple and inexpensive. So this was the start of mobile architecture. How can I do that the house can be transformed as much as possible with the technical means of everybody? After the first war, I was myself a refugee. So I started to think about these things. I got into a new world. A young boy, I had to discover the new world. And that's really, I realized one thing. In this new world, you are leaderless. You are left on your own, on your invention. And I had to invent something. So I was a young architecture student, interrupted in the middle of my studies, getting to a foreign country, and then immigrating to Israel, a country which still didn't exist. So I started to think, okay, how would I translate this new world into architecture? I discovered for architecture, the real important topic is the inhabitant, the person who will live in the place you create. And I discovered in this new world that they are individuals, everybody, with their own idea. So my first discovery was, average man doesn't exist. There are only people. And that's a very big difference. You know, the Bauhaus invented the perfect kitchen, except no housewives wanted it. They were doing it in their own way. Okay, so you have to, as an architect, to design something of people whom you don't know, but who themselves don't know themselves. A housewife who doesn't want the Bauhaus kitchen cannot explain what is the kitchen he wants. So how does the housewife act? He transposes furniture, he transposes all the instruments he's using. That means he follows a way, what's called trial and error. And then you have to find an architecture which permits trial and error. So I proposed, and that's the ville sociale, a skeleton which guarantees that the next floor doesn't fall on your head, and in which people are installed. And I am giving for this always a simple example, the beach. Okay, a beach, imagine the beach as a skeleton, and people implant themselves. And it's an always changing implantation, it's no big means. You put your towel there or here. So this is only a symbol, but the skeleton in which you could move homes like you move towers on a beach, this was in a way the target. If I'm making such a project, that means people have to act to do the process. How I am explaining it to them. And that's where I got into the communication problem. So I tried to write manuals, if you want, instructions for use in cartoon forms, and it worked. People want to build. People are not negativists. You have to give them the opportunity. People can improvise a city. People can improvise architecture. That means the city shouldn't resist for the inhabitants, but should obey the inhabitants. And that was really not understood in the 60s, or misunderstood. Young people understood, people who joined my movement, they were young, my age group. The others, many of them thought it's interesting, but extravagant, it's not normal. And this is, till now, this mainstream, it's not completely understood. Mainstream architecture considers that you are doing drawing, planning studies, and make a strict draft which has to be followed. Yes, we do exactly the opposite. Mainstream architecture forgot the process. The process of mainstream architecture was rigid. Small invention, technical invention, some aesthetical ideas which you can discuss, accept or not, and it was ossified. It became hard. We need to get back to elasticity. And that's the new in architecture, that we understand, perhaps, that architecture is open-ended, an open-ended process. There is no final stage. We were speaking till now about architecture. But it is the problem in town planning too. Town planning, all the town plans work perfectly when people use in the preconceived pattern. But people use it otherwise. And people using otherwise jam a system and makes it inefficient. Why can the system be adapted to other use kinds? So this is, I come back to the ville spatiale. The ville spatiale had minimum impact on the ground. If you want to change a street in Copenhagen, you have to demolish a big number of existing buildings. You cannot change it. Yes, in the ville spatiale, where there are impact points, I don't know, every 60 or every 100 meters, you can change. You can change the street nearly season by season. I could imagine a city which has a summer plan and a winter plan, which is not the same. If there is space available, the technical problem is very low. And So the Wildversiel admitted as well urban design to be adaptable and changeable. All the city concept was based on proximity. You have to be jammed together to be near to your friends, to the grocery store, to everything. This not that the proximity is not anymore imposed will give some new forms of cities. We don't know which one. Again, it comes the laboratory concept. And I think the refugees, this might be one of the laboratory element. How they will settle, we might learn what might be the new form of city. I think that actual mentality in many countries against immigration, it is an error of mentality. Our countries in Europe, they are not overpopulated. Countries like the United States, they are empty. There is place. And I think this migration can bring new mentalities and therefore I'm telling it's a laboratory. Don't forget that the very important cities today, they started by migration. Rome, ancient Rome, was an asylum. People were entering. All the big American cities, they were immigrant cities, very long time. Even now, Los Angeles growth. It works. You know, people who migrate, they bring something new which is useful. I can give you as an example before our eyes, Israel, a country which was created only by immigration. It was an empty, a relatively empty land. It could get 6 million people and who are prosperous. This doesn't depend on the political system. It depends really of the mentality of those who were there originally and those who come in. Places where there was immigration didn't become poor. Generally they became more prosperous. So it is the mentality, how you receive, but as well the mentality of the immigrant, that he understands, I didn't arrive to an inimical country. This sounds that way told, very romantic, sentimental. It is a difficult problem of communication. Like I told in architectural process, communication generally is not understood. People who speak about communication, they think always from the emitter's point of view. And they forget that the receiver's point of view is unknown. And the communication, after my opinion, is less verbal, it's more behavioral. If I am doing something, people will make easily a judgment for or against. If I am telling only in verbs, it's empty, it's abstractions. So it is your behavior and my behavior and everybody's behavior is determining. You see, for the for the refugees, there are two choices. One choice is that you give a territory and tell you make your new city. The other choice is that you enter in that city tissue. How? Most of the buildings in most European countries have flat roofs. You permit to install to a small number of refugees on different flat roofs. I was told the proprietor wouldn't like it. When this involves for him additional admission of additional rental space. That means then it becomes his interest. In Paris, you have stopped, you can do so many square meters. If the proprietor gets sudden 200 square meters, it's enormous. Because it stays his property. Yeah. In this case, the immigrants are dispersed in that tissue. I think that the integration into the existing has an advantage because the new towns, which is right, but sooner or later will produce a conflict. So I think this is possible, and not as an overall situation, but you can try, and in a city it might work, or in a district, and in another district. That's I come always back to the open-endedness, and that's really the way. The Second World War was the result that all policies were strict and not open-ended. It ended at a continent-size conflict. I'm coming back to the trial and error. It is a trial and error. You try it, here it will be successful, there not. Then after a certain number of examples, you take some consequences, and I think that's possible. And there are institutional proprietors, for example, like the city of Paris, they can do the first steps. So I am always trying to avoid conflict. This is my life's experience. So that's, I am taking here my experience as a refugee, my experience that I was every time accepted with sympathetic indifference in every place. I could adapt myself, and they could adapt themselves, and it works. So I think it's not dependent on politicians or parties, on individual attitudes. And that's my message in architecture, and that's my message in social behavior. We are individuals, and okay, and we are able to improvise, and we are able to live leaderless, and we are able to invent. That's enormous. So I am optimistic. Optimism, this doesn't mean that the way is necessarily easy. But if you are optimist, you take a difficult road more easily.